A very pleasant good evening, everyone, and welcome to a special edition of Motorsports Magazine. Tonight from the Lee USA Speedway in Lee, New Hampshire, as well as the Star Speedway in Epping, New Hampshire. Good evening, I'm Rick Knowles. Joining me in the broadcast tonight and returning to the MSM Airwaves, Rob Knowles.
Well, Rick, it's going to be an exciting weekend. Some good racing action down here in southern New Hampshire. And why don't you tell the people what they're going to be seeing at the Lee track as well as Star?
At the Lee USA Speedway, we'll have the NASCAR Winston Racing Series Pro Stocks. A lot of top drivers and some names that our fans will be familiar with competing in that division, Rob.
One name that, one of my favorite drivers at Lee, Danny Bazanson, Buzzy Bazanson's younger brother. He's always one to watch at Lee USA.
Some of the other top competitors at the Lee USA Speedway, Phil Burrill, Eric Hudson, as well as one of my favorite drivers who always finds his way to get to victory lane at the USA Speedway, whether it be bumping somebody off the track or another way, and a driver that you're familiar with, Rob, that's Wayne Helliwell.
Yeah, he's a real good driver in the 77 as well. The A1 of Scott Bonney, he's always up by the top. So there's a lot of good competitors. We've heard that car counts are extremely good at both tracks, so it should be exciting racing.
And with the Busch Grand National North Series in town, just a few miles down the road, scheduled to compete at Star on Saturday, we'll also have some of the Busch Grand National drivers here in their Pro Stocks. Mike Wheaton expected to be in attendance, and whenever Mike Wheaton is around, he puts on a great show.
Well, at Star, the track at Star Speedway, kind of small, kind of like Thunder Road. Many of you are familiar with Thunder Road. And it's going to be interesting. I'm sure it's going to be a real heavy battle just to try to get a starting position in the final race. So it'll be an exciting night, Rick. Don't take the mic away from me ever.
You're long-winded tonight. Some of the top names you can look for in this Busch Grand National North race. Points leader in the division, the driver of the car number 9, Joe Bessie.
Joe Bessie, at the beginning of the year, ran, I'd say, four or five races down with the Grand National in the South. Did a good job down there, and he brought the momentum that he had from down there right up here to the North, and he's really done a good job. He's from Maine.
The guy running second in the points is also from Kennebunkport, Maine. He claims to be Kennebunkport's second most famous resident, and that's Dick McCabe.
Dick McCabe, the Irish Angel, drives the Zero car. Has been driving on the Busch North Series for an extremely long time. Always successful, and one of his favorite tracks is Star Speedway. The last time I was there, Dick McCabe won the race.
Some of the other names to watch for tonight, multi-time Busch Grand National North champion Jamie Obie from North Ferrisburg, Vermont, as well as Joey Karafas in the New England Racing 01.
Joey Karafas is one of your favorite drivers. A lot of very popular names. We're kind of hoping that Dave Dion will be there. Not sure if he will be, but there's a lot of excellent drivers on the Busch North Series, and it should be a real good night.
Special edition of Motorsports Magazine, as the microphones and cameras are on the road. We're filming this opening the day before the races. We are in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean, not too far from a good friend of yours' house, Mr. Busch.
Good friend of mine? I don't know if he's a good friend of mine. I thought he was on your Christmas list.
Well, we'll be joining the president for lunch later on this afternoon, so we're going to have to move on with this opening. And remind everybody to stay with us. Why? Because Motorsports Magazine is next. We'll be right back. Pleasant. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Lee USA Speedway in Lee, New Hampshire. I'm Rick Knowles. Joining me on the broadcast this evening is Rob Knowles, and we get set for NASCAR Winston Racing Series Pro Stocks. Starting on the front row tonight, Rob, the 0-2 of Rick Barrill and the 68 of Brian Short. We're under green here at Lee, first of 25 laps, and we'll have both 25-lap main events from the Lee USA Speedway tonight. They head off turn four to complete lap number one, and the leader is the 0-2 of Rick Barrill.
Barrill leads going into turn one, followed by Alan McClure. Third is the beautiful 17 car. There you see it of Eric Hudson. Coming down into turn three, it's still Barrill.
Two laps complete this time by, and Rick Barrill from Litchfield, New Hampshire is the leader. Now Eric Hudson, and that number 17 car looks to the inside of Alan McClure. Rob, many fans maybe may remember Eric Hudson. He a couple of appearances in an ACT car back in the late 1980s.
Eric Hudson developed a very strong battle when he was first started out racing against Steve Knowlton, and now Knowlton with the ACT, Hudson very strong here at Lee in the Star Speedway.
It's Rick Barrill leading it. Eric Hudson is second. The battle for the third spot between Jeff Fagan in the 10 and the outside car of Alan McClure.
As they head into turn three, slow car that is headed towards the pits, it's still Barrill, followed by Hudson down the front stretch.
One thing you'll notice here about the Lee USA Speedway, a wall around the entire track. It's a tight track, but you do have room to pass.
That's right, Rick. It's a wide track, so you do have that racing room, but if you make a mistake, you pay for it by hitting concrete.
Brian Short, car number 68, is off the pace. He is headed to the pits. Now he's come to a halt off turn four, but I think he'll be out of the way as we see Eric Hudson move to the outside of Rick Barrill.
Eric Hudson, the young driver, moves to the outside of Barrill as they head to turn one. Waiting for any mistake is Wayne Helliwell in the 77.
That's a driver we spoke about in the opening, Rob. He'll do just about anything to get to the lead, so look out, Barrill and Hudson.
And that includes bumping, dumping, whatever. Wayne Helliwell, whatever it takes to get there, that's his motto.
This has been an outstanding race so far. Barrill in the 0-2, Hudson in the 17, and Rob, that 17 car, is, in my opinion, is the best looking race car I've seen this year.
Well, it's one of the best, if not. And Rick, oh, as we see Wayne Helliwell get into Eric Hudson, Rick, from the people we've talked to, the racing here has really been like this all the time.
Keep your eye on the 54 of GG Gravel. He has moved into the fifth spot and is headed toward the front. Gravel, a veteran campaigner out of Groton, Massachusetts. It's been green flag all the way, and Rick Barrill has led all the way. He's challenged by Eric Hudson, Hudson out of Kingston, New Hampshire. And the cars will quickly, Rob, be coming into lap traffic.
A car that we haven't talked about is the 2 of Jim McCallum. As there we see Barrill getting into trouble with the 21 car, and Eric Hudson has to go outside. Rick, trouble.
Yeah, they go through lap traffic, and that really hurt Eric Hudson. He drops all the way back to the fourth spot, and Barrill manages to hold on to his lead, but for how long is Wayne Helliwell is banging on the back bumper?
Boy, there you just saw a case, Rick, where the lap traffic has to get down and let the leaders drive. You don't want lap traffic having an impact on the race.
Wayne Helliwell in the 77. Running in the third spot is Jeff Fagan's 10. Fourth is the 17 of Eric Hudson. GG Gravel runs in the fifth spot in the 54 car. Now he's moved around and picked up another spot.
One of the cars that I had started to mention was the 2 of Jim McCallum, who just 1 week earlier won a $5,000 open pro stock competition, beating the likes of Dave Dion.
Barrill, currently 13th in the point standings at Lee, being challenged by the 77 of Wayne Helliwell, and he's in the third spot. Now cars slowing down. We've got a spin in turn number one. That looks to be the 6 of Damon Tavallaris.
Damon Tavallaris, qualify for the first ACT event earlier this year at the Lee Speedway. Failed to qualify, and now he's got problems.
16 laps complete from the Lee USA Speedway, the NASCAR Winston Racing Series Pro Stocks. The first caution, we get ready to go back to green flag action. And then what a front row. Rick Barill in the 02 and Wayne Helliwell in the 77 as you get a good look at the field of cars here at the Lee USA Speedway. That 1M car, Rob, former ACT competitor Mike Whedon, that's his first appearance in that car this year.
Mike Whedon is always a strong competitor wherever he is. We're set for the restart.
Oh, trouble on the restart. Fagan gets into the side of Wayne Helliwell, and Helliwell is sitting sideways on the front stretch. Jimmy Kuhn's 72 car gets by, as well as the 24 of Gary Casella, but Rob, we're under caution once again.
Well, I think that time on the restart, Helliwell had a little help from behind as he got sideways. Fagan a little bit too quick on the restart.
17 laps complete, 8 laps to go. On the outside, Eric Hudson. The inside, Rick Barill and G.G. Gravel. On the restart, looks to the inside of Hudson, and G.G. Gravel will take the second spot.
They freight train down the backstretch. G.G. Gravel moves in underneath Eric Hudson, and right behind Gravel is the 2 of Jim McCallum.
That's the talk about earlier, Rob, the points leader here at Lee. He won the big race at Oxford just a week ago. Rick Barill trying to go from green to checkers here at Lee. 5 laps remain. Look out, Barill a bit sideways. Here comes Gravel on the inside.
You make a mistake like that with the drivers in this field and you're going to pay, as Rick Barill loses the top spot to G.G. Gravel, and Jim McCallum looks for second.
G.G. Gravel, the veteran from Groton, Massachusetts, will now be challenged by Holland Mass's Jim McCallum. Barill drops back to the third spot, and Eric Hudson runs fourth.
Down the backstretch, it's still G.G. Gravel and Jim McCallum. The cream is at the top of this race.
Now here comes McCallum on the outside. He's running out of laps as Gravel desperately trying to hold on.
Jim McCallum going dirt sideways, coming out of turn 4. Now he goes down the backstretch, making it work on the outside.
There is room to pass it, Lee, and McCallum is making that outside groove work. He's alongside Gravel as they pass the stripe. Rick Barill runs in the third spot, but Rob, this has developed into a two-car battle to the finish.
Side by side driving as we are under 5 laps remaining in the race. Who's going to get it, Rick?
McCallum on the outside has his nose in front at the wire. There'll be 2 laps remaining this time by. It's McCallum on the outside, Gravel on the inside, and now McCallum gets a car length advantage.
This is nothing new from the Pro Stock competitors. Ali again, McCallum sideways. Nothing new from them. They're like this each and every week.
2 laps remain for Jim McCallum as he looks to pick up the win in the first of 2 25-lap Pro Stock main events. But G.G. Gravel is not to be denied. He looks to come back on the inside. 1 to go.
The white flag flies. It's going to be interesting if McCallum goes sideways off turn 4. G.G. Gravel on the inside will make it work and get the checkers as they go into turn 3.
McCallum keeps the number 2 car at the bottom of the racetrack. They come off turn 4. Down the stretch they come, and McCallum will win it by a half a car length.
Well, that happened. Jim McCallum a little bit sideways. He'd been going out of turn 4 like that the past 3 or 4 laps. And he makes it stick on the outside as he wins by a car length, as you call it.
Great race to start Motorsports Magazine for this evening. Jim McCallum from Holland, Mass. Picks up the victory in the first of 2 25-lap main events for the Pro Stocks. Stay with us. We get set for the second 25-lap main event, starting on the inside of row number 1, the 12 of Kurt Gracie, and on the outside, the 64 of Danny Bezanson. Bezanson, a familiar name to ACT fans. Row 2, the 24 of Gary Casella, and the 77 of Wayne Helliwell. Couple other names to look for in this race, Rob. The 1M, as we mentioned earlier, of Mike Whedon, and the 03 of Dan Belisle, brother of former ACT competitor Dick Belisle.
Also in the field, Bobby Gahan, you mentioned Mike Whedon, and Jimmy Kuhn in the 72.
Bezanson gets the jump in the 64, and quickly Wayne Helliwell drops into the second spot. The battle is for the third spot. The 12 of Gracie, the 10 of Fagan, and the 24 of Gary Casella.
As again, we watch the battle now for fourth. On the inside is the 24. Oh, we got trouble, Rick.
Gracie spins, goes into the wall. We got other cars spinning. That's the 6 of Damon Tavallaris and the 02 of Rick Barilla, who had the good race in the previous Pro Stock feature. So it hasn't been a good night for Damon Tavallaris. This is his second incident. And there's the 29 car. That's Steve Carrier. So 4 cars involved. It looks as though everyone's going to be able to pull away. NASCAR Winston Racing Pro Stocks from the Lee USA Speedway on Motorsports Magazine. Danny Bazanson starts on the inside of the front row, and on the outside, the 24 of Gary Casella. Bazanson again gets the jump, and Wayne Helliwell follows him through on the inside. There's that 50 car you spoke about, Rob, of Bob Gahan.
Bobby Gahan is an outstanding short track driver. Last year spent some time with the ACT. As we go back to the front, Rick, it's Danny Bazanson.
Bazanson leads it. Wayne Helliwell is second. Jeff Fagan running in the third spot as he's challenged on the outside by Eric Hudson. Good battle for the lead. The younger brother of Busch Grand National North driver and former ACT driver, Danny Bazanson from Plaistow, New Hampshire, leads it. Wayne Helliwell from Dracut, Massachusetts, runs second. And the third spot, Whalen Mass's Jeff Fagan.
Last year when we were here at Lee, Rick, the Pro Stocks were running similar type bodies as the ACT cars. They've made the change with their Winston Racing Series. And from what we've understand, what we've heard, the car counts have been very good, and the drivers are very happy.
Let's watch Eric Hudson as he looks to work his way through the pack. And again, you're not going to see a better-looking race car than that Hudson automobile.
No, you can tell they do a lot of work with that car because he's going through 2 nights of racing a week here at Lee and Star, and the battles at those 2 tracks are always tight, and I'm sure he's had a lot of dings and dents in that car.
Another car on the move, the A1 of Scott Bonney. He's from North Chelmsford, Massachusetts.
Scott Bonney is another veteran driver of these 2 circuits, and he is another driver always to watch.
Back up front, it's still Danny Bazanson in the lead with Wayne Helliwell right on that back bumper. And as we spoke about in the opening, Rob, at Lee USA Speedway, Wayne Helliwell is always at the front.
Very seldom, unless he's in trouble, do you see Wayne Helliwell at the back of the pack. He's doing a very good job here as we get a nice look at Danny Bazanson in the 64 Howard car. And there's Wayne Helliwell in second. It's been a freight train so far, Rick.
Look out, here comes Mike Whedon. He looks to move on the outside of Jeff Fagan. Whedon, former track champion at Star, former Busch Grand National North champion, had been driving the car number 37. But that car was disqualified last week, and it was the second time. Whedon said he knew nothing about it. It was disqualified for improper tires. So Whedon left that team and is driving this car tonight that is usually driven at Star, Rob, by Norm Wren.
That's right, Mike Whedon, who I have to guess, because he's taken the hood off the car, might have experienced some overheating problems in the first 25-lap feature as he moves to the outside of Wayne Helliwell.
Danny Bazanson has led from the start. He tries to hold on, but he's got 2 tough competitors on his back bumper. As the caution flag is out here at the Lee USA Speedway, we've got trouble at the entrance of turn number 4, and that's again Damon Tavallaris, who is not having a very good night.
Damon Tavallaris is a good driver, but again, every driver has to go through one of these nights, and Tavallaris and the Zelonis Excavating 6 has it.
10 laps complete. We get ready for the restart. Danny Bazanson and Wayne Helliwell in row 1. The 1M of Mike Whedon, the 10 of Jeff Fagan, row 2. Row 3, the 03 of Don Belisle, and the 43 of Kenny Gillis. Bazanson gets the jump, and look who he's got on his back bumper. Whedon tries to take the second spot from Helliwell. It's going to be tough here for Helliwell. He'll have to go by Bazanson or drop back to third.
Dan Bazanson is a good driver. He's going to try to make that car stick on the inside, and he's going to make them pass on the outside, as Helliwell is trying to do right now.
Helliwell on the outside, drops his 77 to the bottom of the racetrack, takes the lead, gets a bump from Bazanson, but Wayne Helliwell is the new leader on lap number 12. Danny Bazanson back to second. Mike Whedon now takes the 1M to the outside. He runs third. The 10 of Fagan is fourth, and the 43 of Kenny Gillis runs in the fifth spot. Don Belisle is sixth, the A1 of Scott Bonney seventh, and the 72 of Jimmy Kuhn runs eighth.
One of the most consistent drivers of the night has been Fagan. Had a good performance in the first 25 lapper, and he's back by the top once again.
Now we look at the 1M of Mike Whedon. Move alongside Danny Bazanson as they head into turn number three. Mike Whedon drops to the bottom of the racetrack, and Mike Whedon is solidly in second.
Mike Whedon shot around Danny Bazanson. He's picked up the second spot. How long can Wayne Helliwell hold off the hard-charging 1M?
Helliwell in the 77 has a five-car length advantage, but quickly Mike Whedon closes that to two-car lengths as they head into turn number two. Now Mike Whedon looks to the outside of Wayne Helliwell. Helliwell is going to make this track awful wide. They get together, some sparks come off the 1M. That's not going to make Mike Whedon very happy.
No, these two drivers are veteran campaigners as they go down the front stretch, and we have a caution, Rick, as Rick Barrill is slowing down in turn two.
Barrill's 0-2 has come to a halt. That'll bring out the second caution flag of this second 25 lapper. The 16 lap mark in the book. We get ready to go back to green. Mike Whedon on the outside, Wayne Helliwell on the inside, Bazanson and Fagan in row number two. And Helliwell gets the jump.
As they go down the front stretch, we'll see if these two cars will pull away from the pack as they were doing. I think, Rick, this is a two-car race.
Now Whedon sticks his nose in front. Helliwell tries to come back on the inside. They come off turn four together. Now Whedon sticks his nose in front at the line. Mike Whedon with a bit more power in the 1M takes the lead going into turn three and quickly brings the car to the bottom of the racetrack. Wayne Helliwell drops back to second, and this one, Rob, is probably over.
Mike Whedon has shown that he is the fastest car on the track. Now that he's in the lead, he doesn't have to deal with any other cars in front of him. We'll see if he's going to run away.
Jeff Fagan takes the third spot. Danny Bazanson drops to fourth, and Kenny Gillis runs in the fifth spot. Scott Bonney is sixth. Eric Hudson now runs seventh.
Eric Hudson's done a good job coming from the back of the pack. Haven't mentioned the name of Bob Gahan much tonight. He's been struggling in the middle of the pack.
Well, if they were to be running this race like the ACT does with the Monza-style features, your winner would be Jeff Fagan. He had a great race in the first event, and he's doing well here in the second, currently running in the third spot.
Where is Fagan in points this year, Rick? Do you have that? One of the nice things that they do at Lee Speedway, they always have an excellent program for the fans to update the points, much like Airborne, to update the points and give the driver roster.
Going into tonight, the leader was Jim McCallum with 195 points. Just 1 point behind in the second spot was the 54 of GG Gravel. Helliwell was third, tied with Scott Bonney with 179 points, and Fagan was in the fifth spot, Rob, with 153 points, and then a tie for the sixth spot between Hudson and Mike Whedon. So Mike Whedon can move up in the point standings here if he can hold on and pick up the victory.
That's right, Mike Whedon all by himself. Good picture there of the 1M car. So that's good for Jeff Fagan. He's obviously doing a good job, and that's a name you and I hadn't heard of when we came to lead tonight.
One lap remains for Mike Whedon, the veteran competitor from Plastow, New Hampshire. He's got a 7 or 8 car length advantage as he heads into turn number three. No problem negotiating the final two turns. Mike Whedon comes off turn four and picks up the victory.
Mike Whedon in the 1M car, successful tonight, and I'm sure he'll hope that he can translate success tonight into success tomorrow night at the Star Speedway.
Wayne Helliwell finishes second, the 10 of Jeff Fagan third, and the 64 of Danny Bazanson finishes fourth. Mike Whedon picks up the victory here at Lee. We've enjoyed our coverage tonight. Stay with us because we've got Grand National North action from Star coming up next.
Motorsports Magazine for the Star Speedway in Epping, New Hampshire. We get set for the qualifying for the Star 150 for the Busch Grand National North. Starting on the pole, the 71 of Bobby Dragon, on the outside, the 51 of Mike McLaughlin.
We go to row two, where on the inside is the 29 of Dave Dion and the 16 of Stubb Fadden.
Jamie Obie and Dick McCabe make up row number three. Barney McRae, Mike Olson, row four. Mike Rowe in row number five. Jeff Berry in the 22 car and Glenn Sullivan in the 34 make up heat number one. Bobby Dragon jumped out to the early lead. The battle is for the second spot. Mike McLaughlin on the outside, Dave Dion on the inside. McLaughlin takes the outside line, moves into the second spot. Dave Dion runs third, Jamie Obie fourth. Dick McCabe on the inside in the zero car runs fifth. Milton Vermont, Bobby Dragon trying to hold off Mike McLaughlin. Dave Dion runs in the third spot. Barney McRae from Colchester, Vermont, Mike Rowe and Mike Olson battle for the seventh spot. Four laps complete. It's still Bobby Dragon leading it. Mike McLaughlin runs in the second spot. Dave Dion from Hudson, New Hampshire runs third. Good battle between Mike Rowe and the 15. He gets around side Barney McRae. Mike Rowe takes over the seventh spot. Now Mike McLaughlin looks to the inside of Bobby Dragon. The Dragon holds him off for the time being. Seven laps will be complete this time by. Bobby Dragon is the leader. Mike McLaughlin runs second. Dave Dion is third. Jamie Obie fourth. Dick McCabe runs in the fifth spot. And Stubb Fadden runs sixth. Two to go for Bobby Dragon. White flag comes out. One to go for Dragon. Mike McLaughlin holds down the second spot. Has two more turns to get by Dragon. He drops back to the inside. Looks like he'll settle for second. They come down the stretch and Bobby Dragon wins heat number one for the Busch Grand National North. Mike McLaughlin finishes second. Dave Dion third. Jamie Obie fourth. And Dick McCabe rounds out the top five. A good run for the Vermont driver, Bobby Dragon. I'm sure a familiar name to all our Motorsports Magazine fans, Rob.
Of course, Bobby Dragon, Rick, the younger brother of Beaver Dragon. Well known, of course, for driving the 75 on the ACT, but great driving there in that first heat for the Busch Grand National North driver.
Bobby Dragon wins it. We'll have heat number two coming up. Number two for the Busch Grand National North, qualifying for the Star 150. And on the inside of row number one, the 35 of Mike Whedon. Starting on the outside, the points leader in the Busch Grand National North from Scarborough, Maine, Joe Bessie.
We go to row two where Dean Ferry of Ontario lines up on the inside outside Essex Junction's Ron Lamel.
In row number three, on the inside, car number one, Tony Hirschman. And starting on the outside, one of the leading rookies in Busch Grand National North, from Northwood, New Hampshire, the 31 of Babe Branscombe.
We go to the next row where inside is the 68 of Martin Truex and outside the 69 of Latham's Jeff Spraker.
Final row from Peru, New York, the 17 of Bob Brunel, and starting on the outside from Williston, Vermont, the 48 of Scott Bichand. 10 cars set to go 10 laps in heat number two for the Busch Grand National North. We are at the Star Speedway in Epping, New Hampshire. a track rod that you and I have been coming to for a lot of years now.
Well, usually the main attraction here at Star Speedway on Saturday nights is the Super Modifieds. The Super Modifieds this week are in Ohio. This week we see the North Tour. Great to see him, Rick. Something you'll notice about Star Speedway, it's a very small track and passing is difficult. You have to be really at your best to make passes here.
Interesting to note, Rob, that later on in the third heat, you will see Robbie Crouch driving a Busch Grand National North car, car number 8, a team out of Vermont.
That's right, his first appearance on the Busch North Tour of the year for Georgia Vermont's Robbie Crouch. Of course, we see him a lot at Airborne. We see him 3 times a year there. We'll see if he can translate success on the ACT to success with Busch North here at Star.
They will go green next time by Mike Whedon in the 35, Joe Bessie in the 9. Row 2, Dean Ferry and Ron Lamel. Tony Hirschman and Babe Branscombe, row 3. Martin Truex and the 69 of Jeff Spraker, row 4. Bob Brunel and Scott Bichon round out the field, and we're under green. Mike Whedon gets the jump on Joe Bessie. Dean Ferry looks to take the second spot on the inside. Ferry gives Whedon a tap in the back bumper. But Mike Whedon will lead lap number 1. The cars run single file into turn 4. Mike Whedon, Dean Ferry, Joe Bessie, Tony Hirschman, Ron Lamel, and Babe Branscombe. Number 1, halfway this time by. Mike Whedon has led from start to finish. The Ontario driver, Dean Ferry, trying to move in. Joe Bessie started outside pole. He's dropped back to third. Tony Hirschman runs fourth. Ron Lamel runs fifth. Now Hirschman looks to the inside of Joe Bessie. Tony Hirschman will take the third spot. Bessie caught on the outside going backwards. And now Ron Lamel looks to move up on the back bumper of Hirschman. 2 to go for Mike Wheaton. Side battle for the fourth spot, but it's going to be Mike Whedon to pick up the checkers. Dean Ferry finishes second, Tony Hirschman third, Joe Bessie picks up a fourth place finish, and Ron Lamel finishes fifth. And well, earlier in the program, Rob, we saw Mike Whedon pick up a pro stock win at Lee USA Speedway, and apparently he's got the hot setup again tonight.
Rick, is that the home court advantage for Mike Whedon? Boy, he's raced a lot of races here, and he looked real good in that heat.
Heat number 2 goes to Haverhill, New Hampshire's Mike Whedon. Stay with us. Well, folks, what we said about heat number 3, forget it. I forgot, it's NASCAR. They time trial for the top 6 spots, so Bobby Gaeta gets the pole. Kelly Moore on the outside. Buzzy Bazanson and Robbie Crouch in row 2. Dale Shaw, Curtis Markham, row 3. Bobby Dragon and Mike Whedon, row 4. Mike McLaughlin, Dean Ferry in row number 6. Kelly Moore on the outside. Buzzy Bazanson looks to push through in the 32 car. Bobby Gaina leads lap number one. The battle is on. Second, Kelly Moore third, Dale Shaw fourth, Bobby Dragon up to fifth. Robbie Crouch caught on the outside of the car number eight. Complete and Bobby Gaina from Connecticut has led from the start. Buzzy Bazanson, that's his new ride. The 32 car runs in the second spot. Kelly Morris third, Dale Shaw fourth. Bobby Dragon and Robbie Crouch battle for the fifth spot. Mike McLaughlin is seventh. Curtis Markham eighth. Dave Dion runs in the ninth spot. And the tenth spot is Dean Ferry. Back further in the field, Mike Wheaton runs 11th, Tony Hirschman is 12th, Joe Bessie 13th, Jamie Obie 14th, Dick McCabe is 15th, Ron Lamel 16th, Scott Batten 17th, Mike Rowe runs in the 18th spot, Glenn Sullivan is 19th, and Mike Olson runs 20th. Bob Brunel 21st, Dave Branson 22nd. Truex in the 68 car runs 23rd. Jeff Berry 24th. Jeff Straker 25th. Barney McRae 26th. And Scott Bershon 27th. 27 starting from the Star 150. Bobby Crouch moving up on the outside. Tries to take over the third spot from Kelly Moore. Crouch moves on the outside of Buzzy Bazanson. Bobby Gaina has opened up a six-car length advantage, but here comes Robbie Crouch. Crouch has made it work on the outside, and he's moved up to the second spot and quickly challenges Bobby Gaina for the lead. Off the Bazanson car. Now Crouch looks to the inside of Gaina, and Robbie Crouch is the new leader. Robbie Crouch started fourth, and after 16 laps, he took the lead. Starting to edge away from Bobby Gaina, who runs in the second spot. Buzzy Bazanson third. Kelly Moore is fourth. Good battle in the middle of the pack. Again, you see more smoke coming off the 32 car of Buzzy Bazanson. He's challenged for that third spot by Kelly Moore. It does appear to be tire smoke coming off the right rear tire of the Bazanson car. Now Kelly Moore takes it to the outside. He takes over that third spot as they come down the stretch. Here comes Dale Shaw. Shaw tries to get underneath Buzzy Bazanski. And there's Bobby Dragon on the outside. Four-car battle for the third spot. Bobby Crouch leads it. Bobby Gaeta second. And that's the battle for third. Kelly Moore takes over third. Now Bobby Dragon moves to fourth. As the Bazanski car is starting to slow a bit. Bazanson heads down toward pit row. Bazanson is out of it. Jamie Obey in the 41 car. Multi-time champion of the Bushman National North Circuit. He works his way around Gene Ferry in the 66. Crouch working his way through lap traffic. He moves around the five car of Barney McRae. Six laps are complete. Another car on the move, the 51 of Mike McLaughlin, also the 29 of Dynamite David Dion. Bobby Gaeta. Bobby Dragon on the move. Now we see some tire smoke coming from Dale Shaw's number 60. But the story of this race is Robbie Crouch. This is his first ride in this car. The Avery Motorsports team taking over the drive from Jeff Barry. To the inside of Curtis Markham. Jamie Obey looks to follow him through. Crouch took over on lap 17 from early race leader Bobby Gaeta. He's opened up distance between himself and Kelly Moore. Crouch getting into heavy lap traffic. The 69 of Jeff Spraker and the 61 of Mike Olson directly in front of him. Caution flag is out. Caution for the first time in the main event is the 32 of Buzzy Bazanson. Still having problems. Bazanson came back on the track. The car was still heavily smoking. And Bazanson will be headed back to the pits. 39 laps are complete, Rob. And I think the story of this... The story of this race is Robbie Crouch.
Rick, that's an understatement. Robbie Crouch is just blistering this Star Speedway track, and he hasn't been here since probably the early 80s. He is absolutely flying. Robbie Crouch in the 8, former car this year of Jeff Barry, Crouch is going to drive that car whenever there are no conflicts between the ACT schedule and NASCAR North. He is flying, and he was pulling away. Kelly Moore doing a good job in the second spot. Bobby Dragon third.
Let's recap the field. Rob just gave the top three. Running in the fourth spot is Bobby Gaeta in his number 36. The 34 of Glenn Sullivan is a lap car. The 51 of Mike McLaughlin runs in the fourth spot. Barney McRae is a lap car in number five. Running fifth is the 7 of Curtis Markham. Next is the 41 of Jamie Obie, and he's really moved up, Rob.
Jamie Obie's doing a good job in the Budweiser car. But boy, Rick, on this Star Speedway track, we've seen a lot of side-by-side racing, and it is difficult to pass, and look at who is behind Jamie Obie.
Dynamite Dave Dion. The Airborne fans don't get a chance to see Dave Dion, so we had to bring the cameras on the road to find him.
Well, it's too bad, because Dave Dion puts on a show everywhere. He's won the Oxford 250 three times.
Dion is followed by Dick McCabe, Joe Bessie, Ron Lamell in the 11, Dean Ferry in the 66, Mike Rowe in the 15, Mike Wheaton in the 35, Tony Hirschman in the 1, the 16 of Stubby Fadden, the 31 of Babe Branscombe, the 68 of Martin Truex, the 69 of Jeff Spraker, the 17 of Peru's Bob Brunel, the 48 of Scott Bichand, the 22 of Jeff Ferry, and the lap car in the back is the 61 of Mike Olson.
Rick, is Bob Brunel still on the lead lap?
I think that caution came out just as Crouch was about to put him a lap down.
To tell you how strong this field is running, there's a look at Stubb Fadden in the 16. Stubb Fadden in the top 5 in points. And he's well back in the field. The 31, Babe Branscombe, has been the champion here 7 times as we've out this set to begin again.
Going back to green, 42 laps complete. Crouch and Moore. Robbie Crouch on the inside, Kelly Moore on the outside, Bobby Dragon looking to stick his nose into the battle. Bobby Dragon gets a bit sideways off the turn, switches it out. The lap car of Glenn Sullivan got in the way of Dave Dion, and Dion tried to move out. Sullivan got a bit loose and got into the side of Jamie Obie.
Well, I think you're right, Rick. Glenn Sullivan holding up the faster cars. Dave Dion and Jamie Obie come together on the backstretch. Folks, I'm sure you're hearing the engines loud and clear on this broadcast. I want to tell you, when you're here at Star, you sit awful close to the track. And Rick, I don't know about your ears, but my ears are ringing as Glenn Sullivan gets the black flag.
Well, Rob, it's probably a good thing that our ears are ringing, because it's making it easier to hear each other. 50 laps are complete. We're a third of the way through. We've had just 2 cautions, so it's been a real clean race so far.
Rick, you think Robbie Crouch can hold him off? His first Busch North race of the year. Really, probably, it's got to be at least his first race in 2 years.
Well, this reminds me a lot of the the old days in the early 80s when the ACT and Busch Grand National North were running as one. We got a battle between Robbie Crouch and Bobby Dragon. Dave Dion and Dick McCabe not too far behind.
Rick, why don't you set the field for us?
51 laps are complete. Row number one, it's the 8 of Robbie Crouch and the 47 of Kelly Moore. Bobby Dragon and Bobby Gaeta run in row two. And what a strong performance we've seen tonight from Bobby Gaeta.
Bobby Gaeta is really doing a good job in the 36. And I'll tell you, he's running in some very fast company. We'll see if he can hold that.
Running in the fifth spot is Mike McLaughlin. In the sixth spot is Curtis Markham from Virginia. Seventh is Dave Dion. Eighth is Dick McCabe. Ninth is Joe Bessie. 10th is Dean Ferry. Mike Rowe runs 11th. Tony Hirschman is 12th. Stubb Baden, 13th. And Babe Branscombe runs in the 14th spot. Going back to green this time by.
Cautions are counting in this race. Cautions count.
Third. Now McLaughlin looks to go underneath Bobby Gaeta. and Kelly Moore will be coming into lap traffic. We got trouble. Martin Truex spinning on the front stretch. Truex loops his 68 coming out of turn four, Rob, and it's been a tough night for that first-year driver. He replaced Donnie Ling Jr. in that car this year.
Truex loses the engine, and Rick, if there's a car that is on the move, I think at this point it's the zero. Boy, I'll tell you, Dick McCabe is coming from the back of the pack, and now he's knocking right on Dave Neon's door panel.
Well, you've had that car in the camera frequently, and he's, I guess you could say, Rob, he's literally plowing his way through traffic with that Fisher snowplow Buick.
Oh!
71 laps are complete. Bobby Dragon, the veteran from Milton, Vermont, is running in the third spot. He's had a real good view of the battle between Kelly Moore and Robbie Crouch for the top spot. Crouch driving the E.J. Prescott Lake Maury Inn car number 8, his first ride in that car this year. And Moore driving the Jordan Lumber car number 47.
Robbie Crouch is really driving his car hard. You gotta wonder how the tires will hold up here. Is Kelly Moore holding something back, Rick? You think Kelly Moore has anything more to give him?
I think it's awfully early in the race, Rob, and I don't think either one of the drivers is showing everything they've got yet.
If not then, then who? Who do you think's going to be up there?
Never count out Dave Dion. Let's recap the field with 72 laps complete in this 150-lap race. Robbie Crouch is the leader. He's led from lap 16. Kelly Moore runs in the second spot. The third spot is held down by Milton, Vermont's Bobby Dragon. Running fourth is Mike McLaughlin. Bobby Gator runs fifth. Dave Dion is sixth. Dick McCabe seventh. Joe Bessie runs eighth. Curtis Markham is ninth. Mike Rowe runs 10th. Tony Hirschman 11th. Dean Ferry 12th. Babe Branscombe is 13th. Stubb Fadden 14th. Jeff Berry 15th. And Mike Whedon is 16th, and I think Whedon showing is a big disappointment so far.
Well, this is the home track. We'll see if he can do it.
Now Dragon looks to the inside of Kelly Moore. Dragon looking to take over the second spot. Kelly Moore shuts the door, pulls that 47 car back into line. The 22 of Jeff Berry is off the pace. Jeff Berry slow in the back stretch, headed toward pit road. Now Mike McLaughlin takes over the third spot from Bobby Dragon. Runs in the fifth spot, and Joe Bessie has moved around a couple cars. He's now sixth. Caution flag out for the fourth time as a couple of back markers, Glenn Sullivan in the 34 and Barney McRae from Colchester, Vermont, come together in turn two. So we've got 80 laps in the books, Rob, and Mike McLaughlin is starting to show the fans here at Epping, New Hampshire, that he's going to be a force to be reckoned with in the latter stages of this race.
Mike McLaughlin driving the Coors Extra Gold Lumina.
He shot by Bobby Dragon that time on that restart. And you're right, Rick, he's going to be one that you're going to have to watch.
In that last series of green flag action, another car that moved up two or three spots was Joe Bessie's 9. He moved around Bobby Gaeta and around Dick McCabe.
Joe Bessie, driver out of the state of Maine. Couple great drivers from Maine right there. Joe Bessie and behind him, the Irish Angel, Dick McCabe.
Joe Bessie is the current point leader on the Busch Grand National North Circuit. Now we've seen Dean Ferry in his 66 car moving up right on the back bumper of the pace car. It appears as though Ferry is headed to pit road, Rob.
Dean Ferry is the only Canadian driver on the Busch North Series. And he is headed to the pits. A very long haul for Dean Ferry out here to New Hampshire. Dean Ferry.
Mike Rowe, who is also running in the top 10, heads down pit road. Now with the caution laps counting and this being a very small racetrack, it's going to be awful important for the crews in the pits to get their work done quickly to keep their drivers on the same lap.
That's right. We've already seen Buzzy Bazanson head into the pits. He came back out for one lap and then eventually went back in himself.
Safety crews are finished work up in turn two. 82 laps are complete. Ferry is back on the track. He does not go a lap down, and neither does Mike Rowe. Both those drivers rejoin the field at the back of the pack.
Can Robbie Crouch hold on to get this victory? The man behind him, Mike McLaughlin, has been flying. Crouch is going to have to drive an unbelievable race to get the victory.
I think it would be a major upset, Rob, if Robbie Crouch were to win this race.
It wouldn't be an upset to see him win any time on the ACT. But to see him come out here his first time, I know he's been test driving the car frequently, but first time in a heavy duty competition like this, he's doing an outstanding job in the EJP, the Prescott Buick.
Well, Rob,
Pontiac, excuse me.
We didn't have a chance to give our pre-race forecast before the start of the race. 84 laps are now complete. Who's going to win it?
Rick, I'm going to take 51, Mike McLaughlin.
Look at that fifth spot and tell me who you see.
The only Ford in the competition, Dave Dion.
I think Dion will win it. 84 down.
Spin.
Sweden is spun out, turn number four. And that will bring out our fifth caution flag of the evening. Caution is out for Mike Whedon, who we spoke about earlier, Rob, is having a disappointing night, but he had worked his way all the way up to 10th, and he got a little tap from behind by Dick McCabe. I don't know if you picked it up or not in the camera.
No, I was following Robbie Crouch up at the front as Kelly Moore has tapped Robbie Crouch a couple times after that last restart. Robbie Crouch is showing surprising power. He's held the likes of McLaughlin, Dave Dion, Joe Bessie's off, and he still sits first. Can he hold him off through this race? That's the question.
Mike Rowe headed back to the pits as well as Dick McCabe.
So your speculation, Rick, that McCabe might have had something to do with Mike Whedon, got to be correct as he heads into the pits.
That wasn't speculation, I saw it.
Oh.
They cross the field over. Robbie Crouch and Kelly Moore in row number one. Mike McLaughlin and Dynamite Dave Dion in row two. Joe Bessie and Tony Hirschman in row three. And Hirschman has really moved up the last few laps.
It's a name we haven't mentioned a lot. He's been consistent, as has the man behind him.
Bobby Gaeta in the 36, run seventh. Bobby Dragon is eighth. I believe Jamie Obie is a couple laps down.
Yeah, as is the 61 car of Mike Olson.
So that would mean the ninth spot would be to Curtis Markham. And the 10th spot right now would go to a guy that we haven't spoke much about. You mentioned him earlier, and that's the racing grandfather, Stubb Fadden.
Stubb Fadden from North Haverhill, New Hampshire. In the top five in points in the North Series, followed by the 31 of Babe Branscombe. We're set to restart, and here is Rick Knowles.
54 laps remain. Robbie Crouch gets the jump on Kelly Moore. McLaughlin and Dave Dion got together a bit. Dion got loose. That's just Joe Bessie, the inside line.
Five laps.
remain for Robbie Krauss, but he's got a mirror full of Kelly Moore to contend with. About a five-car length gap back to Mike McLaughlin and James Dion, running third and fourth. Joe Bessie is fifth. Tony Hurston, sixth. Bobby Gaynor, seventh. Bobby Dragon is eighth. Is starting to drift a bit high in the turn. Maybe the tire's starting to leave the crowd car. Kelly Moore has been able to get underneath him coming out of turn four the last couple times. Now Kelly Moore looks to the outside. Down the back stretch. Kelly Moore putting all sorts of pressure on Robbie Krauss, but it's still Krauss at the line. Moore is off the back stretch. Kelly Moore is spinning. I don't know what Kelly Moore was trying to do there, because he really was putting a lot of pressure on Robbie Krauss. Lost it going down the backstretch. There's still 35 laps remaining in this race. He might have made his move a bit too soon.
Kelly Moore, after trying to look for a hole inside of Robbie Krauss, Krauss, the veteran, did not give one, decided to look high. Really abusing the tires was Kelly Moore. And I think eventually, Rick, the tires started to go away and he got loose there. And Kelly Moore's chances of winning this race are out the window. Robbie Krauss has survived one test from Kelly Moore. Test number two sits behind him and Mike McLaughlin.
What a restart this is going to be. Krauss on the inside, McLaughlin on the outside, and Dave Dion in the third spot. I don't know if you noticed it, Rob, but a few times we've seen Robbie Krauss drift high coming out of the turn, so maybe there's some tire wear starting to show on that number eight car.
Wouldn't be surprised, Rick, but I gotta think most of the cars in this race have really put a lot of wear and tear on their tires, and I don't think Robbie Krauss is alone. There's been, as we mentioned earlier, you have to work extremely hard to get one position here. And that puts a lot of wear and tear on the tires, but I think everybody is going to be in the same boat Robbie Krauss is. Can he hold them off? We've asked that now about four times.
Now, the longer this race goes under caution, the better chance Robbie Krauss has of winning. But right in his back bumper and alongside are the two guys that you and I picked to win this race. Mike McLaughlin from your side and Dave Dion from my side. Tony Hirschman is up to fourth. Bobby Gaeta running fifth. Stubb Fadden is sixth. Babe Branscombe is seventh. Dean Ferry is eighth. Dick McCabe ninth. And Mike Rowe runs 10th. The top 10 with 32 laps remaining. 118 laps in the book. And they'll go green next time by.
119 in the books and set to call the action. Rick Knowles, or is Ronnie Crouch going to do it?
I don't know. Dave Dion riding way right there. Look at Mike McLaughlin power up on the outside. But there's Crouch to shut the door. We got Mike Whedon spinning. Mike Whedon spinning in turn number two. Whedon gets his 35 cars back underway, so there will be no caution. Crouch in the eight is the leader. Mike McLaughlin, a looming presence on the outside. Dave Dion runs in the third spot. Tony Hirschman is fourth. working his way through lap traffic. No problem around Scott Bichon and Dale Shaw. Laps to go this time by. Impressive performance by Robbie Crouch. I think a lot of the fans here didn't realize that Jamie Obey in that 41 car was a few laps down as he put on a heck of a challenge, but last few laps you saw the starter come out with the passing flag to Jamie Obey to let him know that Robbie Crouch was the leader and don't mess around with him.
I think actually, Rick, Jamie Obey might have got into Robbie Crouch one time, but boy, Robbie Crouch has dominated a lot of races over his career at NASCAR in the ACT. But he ran away with one tonight, and he was just brilliant. A great performance by Robbie Crouch.
You see Crouch pull into victory lane. Mike McLaughlin finishes second. Dave Dion finishes third. And what a run for the rookie, Rob. Babe Branscombe from Northwood, New Hampshire finishes fifth.
Not surprising, Babe Branscombe, as we mentioned earlier, their seven-time Pro Stock champion here at the Star Speedway. Good run for Babe Branscombe, who's in a tight battle with Curtis Markham for the Rookie of the Year here on the Busch North Series.
Boy, and I'll bet there are a lot of people at ACT headquarters in Waterbury, Vermont, with big smiles on their faces right now.
You think Robbie Crouch just showed some of these NASCAR boys, Rick?
Well, I'll tell you what, you got to give the NASCAR boys a lot of credit. You didn't. One thing that impressed me was this was a really clean race, Rob, and not a lot of cautions. The cautions were for incidents such as Bazanson's tire problem up here in turn one, the blown engine from the 68 car. Really impressive performance by these drivers. They put on a great show. It's not often you see a 150-lap race, Rob, run in less than an hour clock time.
Wow. It was a real good race, Rick. For Robbie Crouch, he'll load up here, then take his ACT car down to Thompson, Connecticut. As we film this, the ACT set to run a modifieds on the asphalt.
Well, we invite everybody to stay with us because this is not the end of Motorsports Magazine for this evening. Not yet. One more race still to go. We're going to have the Pro Stock portion of the Star 150. 30 laps for the NASCAR Winston Racing Series Pro Stocks from here at SAR. So stay with us. The Pro Stocks are coming up next.
Great race.
We get set for NASCAR Winston Racing Series Pro Stock action from the Star Speedway. 30 laps for the Pro Stocks. Let's set the field. Inside row number one in car number 33 is Tom Dean. Starting on the outside in the 44, Jimmy Rosenfield.
Inside row two, the travel man, Pete Bandaka. And outside, the 1M of Norm Wren.
In row number three, on the inside, I'm sure you're familiar with him, former ACT driver, Busch Grand National North driver from Barrington, New Hampshire, the 50 of Bobby Gahan. And starting on the outside, the A1 of Scott Bonney.
We go to the next row where we find on the inside the 73, that being driven by Tom Quinney, and the 54 of G.G. Gravel.
Row number five on the inside, the 64 of Danny Bazanson. On the outside, the 66 of Bobby Cabral.
Next row, Eric Hudson in the 17, nice-looking car. And outside him is Alan McClure.
Final row, the 58 of Flying Phil Barreau, and starting shotgun on the field, Mike Murphy and car M3. 30 laps, we're ready to go. Jimmy Rosenfeld takes the lead. Pete Fiandaca moves into the second spot. There comes Bobby Gahan looking to the inside of Tom Dean. Three wide action here at Star as the 33 car of Tom Dean is headed to the back. Look out, we've got trouble. Bobby Cabral, 66, is involved, as well as the 17 of Eric Hudson, the M3 of Mike Murphy. And I think what really caused that incident, Rob, was that the 33 car of Tom Dean really didn't belong at the front and had nowhere to go but backwards.
Well, he got sandwiched there. Behind him, Eric Hudson was coming quickly. And as you mentioned, he was the meat in that sandwich.
Two laps are complete. We're under caution for the first time at Star. Getting ready to go back to green flag action, the 66 of Bobby Cabral is in the pits, as well as the 135 of Peter Fiandaca, who was not involved in that incident. So mechanical problems bothering Fiandaca, and he will go down a few laps. Jimmy Rosenfeld gets the jump on Bobby Gahan as we're back under green. Rosenfeld in the 44, Gahan in the 50. Gahan looks to the outside. Tom Quinney waiting for one of those two to make a mistake. Scott Bonney runs in the fourth spot. Norman Wren is fifth. Danny Bazanson sixth. G.G. Gravel seventh. Alan McClure is eighth. Here comes Gahan on the outside for the lead. Four laps into it. Bobby Gahan is the new leader. Jim Rosenfeld is back to second. Former American-Canadian Tour driver Tom Quinney runs in the third spot in the 73. Bobby Gahan starting to pull away from Jim Rosenfeld as the 44 car may be slowing up the rest of the field. They're starting to bunch behind him. Now Quinney looks to the outside. Here comes Scott Bonney in the A1 on the inside. Norman Wren in the 1M runs fifth. the battle is for third. Bonnie on the inside and Quinny on the outside. Scott Bonnie takes the third spot. Norm Wren moves right underneath and takes fourth. So Tom Quinny is following back on the outside. Now G.G. Gravel will pick up a spot in the 54 car. The battle is for the second spot. Bobby Gahan has opened up about a 15 car length advantage. If it goes green the rest of the way, I don't see anyone catching Gahan. 12 laps are complete. 30 laps make up the distance for this main event for the NASCAR Winston Racing Series Pro Stocks. Danny Bezanson has taken over the fourth spot in the 64. As Norm Wren is caught on the outside. Another car on the move, the 54 of G.G. Gravel. He got into the back end of Norman Wren. See some of the back sheet metal disappearing on that 54. Bobby Gahan now with a two-turn advantage. As Danny Bezanson is desperately trying to get by Jim Rosenfield. Scott Bonnie runs fourth. Norm Wren is fifth. G.G. Gravel on the outside tries to get by Wren. Tom Quinny is running seventh, Eric Hudson is eighth, Alan McClure is ninth, and Mike Murphy is tenth. Ten laps to go for Bobby Gahan, but we continue to focus in on the battle for second. Bezanson has taken over second, Rosenfield back to third. Eric Hudson and Tom Quinny battling for position in the back of the pack. Look out! Hudson gets into the side of Tom Quinny, and the 73 car goes around. Quinny refires. There you see the leader, Bobby Gahan. And right now, Bezanson is entering turn four. Norman Wren in the 1M trying to move up on the outside of Jim Rosenfield. Wren is the defending track champion here in the Pro Stock Division at Star Speedway. Five laps remain for Bobby Gahan. Danny Bezanson runs second. G.G. Gravel is third. Norm Wren fourth. Scott Bonnie takes over the fifth spot. Jim Rosenfield back to sixth. Eric Hudson seventh. Alan McClure is eighth. Remain for Bobby Gahan. The 73 of Tom Quinny is a lap car. One to go, and right now Gahan could coast the victory. Bobby Gahan picks up the checkered flag. The Downey's Drilling 50. Gahan from Barrington, New Hampshire. Danny Bezanson finishes second. Gigi Gravel third. Norman Wren fourth. Scott Bonney fifth. Eric Hudson got the sixth spot. Alan McClure seventh. Jimmy Rosenfeld eighth. Mike Murphy ninth. And flying Phil Baril finished 10th in the 58. And Rob, there was no catching Bobby Gahan tonight.
Once Bobby Gahan got to the lead, he just ran away with it, Rick. And like you mentioned, there was nobody who was going to catch Bobby Gahan on this night as he covered the field by half a track.
Good battle for that second spot in the middle stages of the race. It looked as though Rosenfield was holding up traffic.
A lot of good driving by the likes of Danny Bezanson, who we see here in the picture, Gigi Gravel, as these cars wait to get weighed after the race. There's Norm Wren. All that middle of the pack did an outstanding job. Really good race, Rick.
Well, that's going to wrap up Motorsports Magazine for this evening, Rob. We've really enjoyed bringing the fans a taste of the NASCAR Winston Racing Series as well as the Busch Grand National North from Lee USA Speedway and here at Star. And hopefully we'll be able to have some more action from the NASCAR Series next year.
Well, Rick, you and I have known about these tracks for a long time, and we've come down here and enjoyed the racing for a lot of years. Really, it's good racing, and if anyone is ever vacationing down in this area, kind of encourage them to check out Lee or Star Speedway.
Lee USA Speedway, located on Route 125 in Lee, New Hampshire. They race every Friday night with a 7 o'clock post time. The Star Speedway, Route 27 in Epping, New Hampshire, Saturday nights at 7.
The only unfortunate thing, Rick, is we missed the Super Modifieds this year as we came down on our vacation. Boy, I'll tell you, my favorite class to watch in all of racing, the Super Modifieds. Too bad we missed them this year.
Well, we'll be back down here with the cameras in October, filming the Oktoberfest from Lee USA Speedway. Maybe even some more coverage from the Super Modifieds here at Star. We'll have to wait and see how that works out. But nonetheless, we've enjoyed our coverage from Star and Lee. We hope you have too. So for my analyst this week on Motorsports Magazine and cameraman Rob Knowles, I'm Rick Knowles. Until next time, have a good night, everybody.